Ah, yes, Earl Hebner, senior official for WWE, former, I should say. Look, folks, I'm not here to say whether or not Earl Hebner was in the right or wrong. I just don't really know the full story, to be perfectly honest with you. I wasn't watching wrestling anymore in 2005 or 2006 when he was released from WWE, supposedly for selling WWE or WWF merchandise illegally without permission in some store in St. Louis that he had part ownership with. Him and his brother Dave was also released from WWE for the same stuff. Again, I don't know all of the details, but you know, it just goes to show that at the end of the day, it's all about money. I mean, think about it. Earl Hebner was with WWE, what, since like the 80s, right? And because he tried to make some extra money, he was released. You know, WWE felt that it was a conflict of interest and he was earning money and his brother was earning money without their consent. I can totally understand that. I'm sure things could have gone way worse than just being released. But it just goes to show that, you know, sometimes there's no loyalty from both sides, you know? Again, I don't know every little detail. I don't know whether or not it was just extra money or Earl Hebner and his brother were hurting for money. Who the heck knows, you know, all the details. I mean, if you know more information than I do, feel free to let me know in the comment section. But hey, I was always an Earl Hebner fan, okay? You know, whenever he would officiate a match, you knew it was going to be fair for the most part, right? It's just like, it's crazy. You know, Earl Hebner's gone. Tim White, has passed on. Mike Chioda no longer refs for the WWE. You know, it's just like, you know, a lot of people forget about that. Teddy Long was no longer a referee. Teddy Long became the, hey, player, you know, which I wasn't a huge fan of Teddy Long's run. What was he like, the commissioner or the Raw general manager or SmackDown general manager, whatever. But what was going on with the Earl Hebner thing? That's what I want to know. Sorry for the trains in the background. Was his release or was him selling WWF merchandise illegally? Like, you know, was it of malicious intent? Was it to get back at the company or was it just to make extra money? I'm assuming the latter. But again, not knowing all the details is pretty crucial. But it is something I wanted to talk about because I was just reading about it on his Wikipedia. Because I've been going back and watching a lot of the old episodes of Raw, SmackDown, and pay-per-views from 2000 to 2003. I've been watching them on WWE Network / Peacock or whatever, where they're hosting WWE Network now. And I've just been watching all these old matches, so I've been naturally looking things up and, you know, coming up with topics to make for the channel here. But yeah. What do you guys think? What was going on with him with the merchandise selling? You know, what was it? Was it fake merchandise? Was it legit? Was it a little bit of both? I'm not really sure. But let me know in the comments. And if you made it to this point, comment Earl1141. Earl1141. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Turn on all notifications. Crush that like. And until next time, keep watching wrestling. And we'll keep talking about it.